Hey everybody, it's Footerware. Welcome back to P.T.O. So, we're going to start off by getting ships chosen for the 9th fleet. Yes, we are creating a new fleet right now, because I'm getting not concerned about what the submarines are doing, but there is an increase in submarine presence from the Allies, and I just want to get one more fleet out there just to even the odds a little bit. I don't care how ineffective destroyers can be. This will at least help me out just a tad. So, there's going to be a bit of shuffling ships and creating fleets and stuff in this part, because we're trying to prepare for a lot of attacks here, and that's going to include building up a super fleet of sorts for my number 2 fleet as the main invasion force for Sarong. I mentioned on numerous occasions that Sarong is quite scary, has a ton of troops, and could be a pain in the neck, really. So the 3 fleet's going to be kind of weak for right now, but since I don't intend to have them leave port, I don't expect this to be a major issue. Sarong isn't really loaded on planes anymore since I keep bugging them. And that's going to continue as I start actually sending air forces at them. So that's going to be the update on Sarong at this point. But as you also see, our 7th fleet is at Jakarta, and Jakarta's been getting assaulted a little bit, and we've been getting assaulted back, including the point where we lost the troop transport. Ouchies. That's not exactly the thing I wanted to see, since cruisers can only carry one battalion at a time, so that's not good. But because there's no troops, and because we have one troop transport remaining, it's clear that we've actually landed all our troops at this point, so that is a bit of a relief, although I am going to miss that transport. Meanwhile, on my end, we're going to continue the mugging of Vladivostok. So, here comes another battle. This should be a real formality. All I need to do is cut down the field to 0, and we'll be on our merry way. There's 2 troops there versus our 8. That is a very one-sided affair in our favor, for once. And yes, we actually get hit by 4 freaking bombers. What a load of BS. But at least the fighters go down. So with that in mind, our object is going to be to try to eliminate the fuel, because there's still a healthy amount of troops remaining, and it just seems like the stubborn AI likes to send out half their presence at this point. Kind of sucks. So what we're going to do now is just go right after the fuel. That's the way it ought to be. 26,000 remaining, we should be down, and we should have this base taken by the end of the battle. Except, I make one stupid decision and it costs me. The AI is so dumb, and really me, for overestimating the AI. My planes flew atop the city, meaning my troops could not go in and take it over. So when I knocked down the fuel to 0, I couldn't take it over! So the base is still allied for now, essentially a long-winded stalemate, but at least next time, I'll be aware of it, and next time is just going to be a cheap airstrike because I'm lazy. So, blast the one troop, and then I'm getting the hell out of the way! Freak this game and its dumb AI at times, I'm getting all my everything's out. I'm not staying near. I'm just going to just wait my turn, let the AI go and take the city on its own, and we will have our first base. Just like that. So, that's the first one down from us. It took too long, and I'm not very pleased with it, but this is a base that needed to be taken. It's rather out of the way, despite its proximity to Japan. So, I looked at Vladivostok a little bit. Translates to ruler of the east. Well, now it's being ruled by us, but hey. It's known as being a terminus for the Trans-Siberian Railway. 7 days to Moscow, I believe, or is it no, it's not 7 days, maybe 7 hours. It's 7 something. I'll check it out. It's the home port of the Russian Pacific Fleet, the largest port they have, and it also had a significance in the Russian Civil War in the early 1900s, 1918 to 1922. When Allied forces were trying to intervene against the Bolshevik rule in favor of the Czechoslovak White Russians. One of the members of the Allied forces was the Japanese. The Allied forces eventually withdrew, unfortunately, for them, and around, I think, 1920, but the Japanese stayed a couple extra years and then eventually retreated. Bolsheviks would later take it back. So, nothing really was accomplished there. Given the fact that Vladivostok's so close to so many Japanese bases, I don't anticipate that anybody's going to be dumb enough to try to take it over. They'd have to get past Kure, Shanghai, Seizbo, and Daren and Seoul. You're not doing that. You're just not. So, I'm just shuffling my subs right now, getting them ready just to patrol once again, same as always, really. Nothing really out of the ordinary there. So, that concludes that. You notice really quickly how just taking one base really shot my morale up quickly. It's now 99, the highest it can be. Kind of crazy how that works, but you also see how my aggressive play causes my fatigue to go up so fast. 91. Fatigue goes up regardless, rest just slows it down. But when you're constantly attacking, well, that happens. And just showing you where Peking is, because they were shelled earlier in the turn from Namanhan, the only Allied base in the area. But I don't want to lose Peking for obvious reasons. Having another inland base can be a real pain in the neck. They can attack Nanking, Daren, say Seoul, and that could create a domino effect that I don't want. So, with that in mind, I want to make sure that doesn't happen again. Namanhan is notoriously weak, though. So, what kind of shocks me that they're actually trying to shell things. When you start the game, Namanhan has exactly one fighter and one bomber. I kid you not. Not exactly a scary base. But what is scary is when that one Allied fleet sees my number 4 fleet with its carriers. Have fun. And Jakarta is now ours, so I'm very pleased with that development. It's kind of an annoying base to take because of all the planes, but it does keep Banjar Armisen safe, which was a main goal. Unfortunately, it is still vulnerable because it's got to deal with Singapore nearby, and maybe Kuala Lumpur as well, which is not pleasant. So, I expect there could be some shellings along the way, that's fine. Meanwhile, speaking of which, our 4th fleet just struck the San Juan, it's gone, see you later. That fleet is going to continue to get theirs, and it's not going to be pretty. Speaking of not pretty, my 8th fleet's going to also be on the pursuit of that submarine. And here we go again. And the Tarpon's not going to last very long at this rate. I just have too much firepower there, it may try to bail, I'm not going to let it happen. Thankfully, subs are extremely slow, so it's not a question of whether they're going to run of whether I'm going to catch them. It's a question of when. So, as you see, I got things pretty well in hand here, going after the Tarpon one more time, and this time it does not survive. Tarpon actually was patrolling in Japanese waters for a lot of the war, but it did actually survive, if I remember. Meanwhile, our 9th fleet's ready to go, so I'm going to have it do some searching actually around some of the bases that have been ours for a very long time, Hong Kong, Shanghai, Taipei, Tainan, just keeping things on the up and up there. You never know with submarines, you never know where one could be hiding out. That's always the thing about these submarines, you never quite know. I mean, if they're ballsy enough to patrol your home base, imagine what they could do for other bases. I mean, there's no base that's sacred, as far as I'm concerned, except for inland bases, because they can't get there. But knowing this game, it wouldn't surprise me if a glitch happened where it could happen. Of course, I'm not aware of a glitch. I'm sending my 6th fleet now to the Bayak, just to meet up with the 3rd fleet, get that fleet meshed together, and get myself actually a respectable 3rd fleet, while their number 1 fleet is now deploying to take out the transports there. Of course, they will not take out Marshall, because who cares about Marshall if you're the Allies? I will never ever understand that, as long as I live. Because that's always my first target whenever I deploy a fleet. Take Marshall! Why not? Well, I actually do that from my own personal experience, but hey, neither here nor there. Meanwhile, now the Smith is down, just the Juno remains. You imagine how that's going to last. I'm actually a little bit concerned now to actually see that there's a one fleet nearby, because that just means in a matter of a few days, my four fleet could be overwhelmed by them, depending on how powerful it actually is. I don't know yet. However, it's something that's in the back of my mind right now. Meanwhile, our two fleets do an incredible job just dishing on Sarong. No, they're not going to take the entirety of the fuel down. It'll probably be troops or a surrender that go first. It would take a minimum of like 20 battles or so to actually get rid of that much fuel. And probably you'll have better luck with the troops at that rate. Meanwhile, the Juno is gone. There goes the number 3 fleet. And that was a very rather short, undistinguished career for that fleet. Meanwhile, our 11th fleet now just spotted a submarine. So, looks like there's a little more activity there than we were left to believe. I mean, when you have that scary number 1 fleet probably patrolling around, you gotta keep an eye on that. And, well, maybe the submarine's a bit, maybe it's a smokescreen, one trying to favor the other, or whatever, I don't know. Doesn't really work that way, but hey. I like to think of it like that. Meanwhile, we're done here. It's time to send our fleet back down, and really, all the bases in the vicinity are Japanese, so we're gonna have to travel a while to actually catch up on a base. Meanwhile, our two fleets handling business with the planes. This really reduces danger for Bayek being bombed, which is a good thing. Sarong does like to have their planes, and it looked like they did refuel them, and it turned out they did. They gave them more planes, didn't really touch the troops, and of course they didn't touch the fuel because the fuel was maxed out previously, for sure. And our 8th fleet is now going after transport squad because I don't think I've turned them loose for that. Meanwhile, our 11th fleet just spotted that fleet! That's the number 1 fleet, and 3 aircraft carriers, 3 battleships, 3 cruisers, 5 destroyers. There is one word for that. Yikes! As in, really major yikes. 9th fleet's gonna go to Hanoi just to patrol the area once again, see if I bump into anything. With any luck, there might be a sub there. So, ugh. That 1 fleet is brutal. And you know what makes it even worse? Is that, in all likelihood, there are ships there that were previously teleported there thanks to my ability to knock down their engines to zero without me wanting to do it. I'm also taking the time to now finish up what my objective with the 6th fleet was. Merge my carriers with the 3 fleet, and create a 6th fleet to patrol around the area. So, now I've killed 2 birds with 1 stone, it's time to send the 6th fleet off to patrol, look for subs, etc. And it's time for my 3 fleet to now join in on the assault at Sarong. So, killing 2 birds with 1 stone. The 6th fleet, I'm not gonna lie, is probably my weakest fleet, and I probably made it too weak, actually, thinking about it. Because I gave the 9th fleet 4 destroyers, and I'm giving this one 3. Probably should have given it a cruiser. Made it a little easier. Unusual to see the 1 fleet going after Wake's transports. They must have really been straying. Actually, what they probably are, they're probably somewhere between Marshall and Wake at this point, which means they're probably heading towards the Marianas. The 2 fleet's going to continue the attack on Sarong. Nothing really is going to change there, and really there's not going to be much changing until they start landing troops. Which is going to be kind of a pain, but whatever. The 11th fleet also just spotted 2 subs. So 3 fleets, but hey, at least it proves the value of me putting a fleet at Marshall to see what's going on. Because this really is a huge advantage for me. Despite me being completely not ready for it, at least I have the information I'm waiting for here. If I was a little more proactive, maybe kept a few fleets patrolling the area, I probably could have done more. But whatever. You're also going to see me do this, where I'm detaching my aircraft carriers, and the reason I do this is because I simply don't trust the RNG, and I don't trust the AI. For all I know, they could do a land attack, and randomly ships get damaged, and it could be my aircraft carriers. Why the hell would I want to lose an aircraft carrier to a silly land invasion? That would be an incredible loss. No base is worth that for me, as far as I'm concerned. So I really don't like to see that. Needless to say. And I'm sending my 4th fleet away after the killing. I'm going to send it over to rest, refuel, but more importantly, get away from the 1 fleet. Because that my 4th fleet's good, but it ain't going to win that. So by tailing the fleets and by looking at their constant positions, I'm coming under the impression that they're going to be going for the Marias. Well, I'm going for Manila, though. Manila is the closest ally base to me, and it's a very high-value base. I might as well just go right for it, take it there, complete the Philippine conquest, and get that dry dock. Meanwhile, as you see, we are taking out a healthy dose of Sarong's army. We lost the landing force, which meant it could have been a disaster. However, I suspect the allies are going for the Marianas, and that includes Palau and Yap. I don't know where, I don't know what, and I don't know when it's going to get there, but it'll probably get there in a few days if I had to guess. That's just my belief, judging by all the positions and looking them over. Eventually, the 11th fleet is going to lose track of it because I'm going for any subs, and I'm going to just pass it off to the 12th fleet that's in the area, my other subs. But I suspect that the Marianas are once again going to be a very high-value target, because they just seem to always be a high-value target. It's like wrong place, wrong time, essentially. It's almost like the middle of all the bases, for all intents and purposes. It kind of is. I mean, the Wake might be in the very middle of the map, but look at all the bases around it. There ain't too many. So the Marianas might be the hub, if you will. So, that's what we got to look forward to. It's going to be pretty brutal. I'm not looking too forward to it. Well, at least Manila is looking pretty weak right now, so that should be a lot easier than Sarong is, and because it's me, it's going to take a little less time. And because I'm not going to let the AI screw me over this time. No way. Ninth Fleet just spotted a sub. That's great news. And it's the Dolphin. 1 sub, it looks like. So we should have our way with them. Our 11th fleet continues to spot that dreaded ship, just that dreaded fleet, and now we're going to get attacked by the sub. This is going to happen frequently, where we're going to get attacked, they're going to get attacked. Namonhan's going to get attacked now, sort of us saying to Namonhan, hey, you got a little loud just now, calm it down a little bit. Peking went after them, Seiz was going after them, we just took Bangkok, that's even better since that's a seaside base. That one was a really lucky break. I did not expect that, but I have seen Bangkok surrender when I played as the Allies before, so it's not out of the question to see that. But hey, lucky break for us. Meanwhile, Jakarta is getting attacked by Singapore, which is basically we're being shelled, except there's ships there, so it ain't we're being shelled. It's, you know, a legitimate attack. And our attacks continue. So pretty high activity. Very glad to get another base on our side. I gotta get the 7th fleet out of there. Not worth having them hang around. And just getting back to Banjarmasin. Jakarta is tough. It should last for a little bit. Not as tough as Sarong is, of course. And oof! Nagara got hit a little bit there. But that's fine. So that was not a very smart move of my... Well, I expected the damage, really. I expected the damage. Meanwhile, our 9th fleet is going to continue the assault on the 13th fleet. This is going to last way too long. If I could view the battle, I would. But then that means I'd have to view every single freaking battle, and I don't want to do that. They really flawed the settings here. Meanwhile, 15 fleets, a truck, a salmon got damaged. Whoops. That's pretty inept when you're getting attacked by convoys and damaged. So our number 3 fleet's now going to join the fray. take out some more troops, speed this up because it really needs to. And unfortunately, I forgot to take out the aircraft carriers, as you see. Luckily, no harm, no foul, given it was nighttime. But not something I was very pleased with, so I'm going to proceed to break off them and actually join them with my other aircraft carriers. Now, if you're wondering why I'm not having my aircraft carriers attack, it's partially because I just don't trust the AI and partially because of my own little, stupidity. I could easily have the 13th fleet, that is, break out a little bit, send it over, and then order them to do attack enemy base, which means they would go right at Sarong, eventually do a land attack, but in the meantime, do a bunch of bombings which could do massive damage. Unfortunately, I didn't think that far ahead, and it's too much micromanaging for my liking. Meanwhile, I'm getting my escorts ready because I expect Manila's going to test me at some point. And right now, as you see, the two and three fleets are starting to take out about four battalions a battle. That's very healthy. It means that Sarong probably is not going to last much longer. Maybe, like eight more battles or so. I mean, it goes down pretty quick when you're taking out eight battalions a turn. That does add up. And 8 battalions a turn, or really 16 battalions a day. So, well, that's what, 3 days? It's probably advantageous for me. Meanwhile, Manila looks like they're going to go after me because there's nothing else in the area. So, what are they going to test me with? They're going to test me with 1 lone bombing air force with 12 bombers. Well, that ain't going to last long. Boom, next. What do we got? Well, with that out of the way, they've already spent their turn, so they're going to have to recoil before they attack again. I'm not going to give them the opportunity. I'm landing right now. Next turn, there's going to be hell to pay for even trying to scratch my fleet and failing miserably, I might add. Meanwhile, there's a Night Fleet stalemate still going on, but it will win this battle of attrition eventually. It just might take a while. Oh great, the dolphin now can't hurt me. Anyway, that's going to end this part, so see you when we attack Manila. Later, 40 Warriors, signing off.